today, Babezilla here with Spider-Man on Hollywood Boulevard, and today we're talking oil. So, Spider-Man, oil has hit $100 a barrel. What do you think about that?
I think it's terrible, and I thank God that I don't drive. I web myself everywhere, because Spider-Man couldn't afford to drive anywhere. Neither can anybody else in America, by the way.
Oil prices are high, $100 a barrel. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, my thoughts are, this is what happens when we get under a regime that's treating us very, very poorly. And they control everything. They're controlling the prices. There's absolutely no threat to the oil at the moment. Even though there is a war going on in the Middle East and there is an uprising, there is no threat to the oil supply. The oil supply is flowing freely, but they have raised the prices dramatically.
I think it's gorgeous. Yeah, especially on the dollar market with the crude oil. Oh yeah, that's a bundle of barrel there on the stock market, you know. Oh yeah, that's more entertaining for our pockets. Oh yeah.
Do you think we can solve this problem in the Middle East that's going on right now?
I don't know that we can. I think that they need to solve their own problem. I think all the demonstrations are showing that some countries want democracy. But no, I don't think that the major oil companies want anything to change.
Now, what about the Middle East? How can we solve the problems there?
Oh, Middle East, how we solve? Make a peace treaty. Make a peace treaty. Make it brand new, too. And get Gaddafi out of office, too. Oh, yeah.
Okay, getting a little political now.
Oh, yeah.
So, you have to talk. Through violence and through fighting and through bombing. If we send bombs in there right now on our airplanes and our boats, it would be the worst thing that we could do. It has to be resolved through talking, finding out what the other side wants and what it would take to bring peace to the Middle East.
Now, corn is a hot commodity, and it's kind of been used for ethanol. Do you think the price of corn and food has also affected the price of gas?
Well, it's the other way around, I believe. I think it's the price of gas that affected the price of corn, because you have to transport it, and transporting it needs oil, and it's costing more to transport it. So I feel it's the other way around, actually. Everything relies on oil, and they understand that they have it. For lack of a better way of saying it, excuse me, but they have us over a barrel. So until we get off that grid, off that line, and switch to something like hydrogen or switch to something like electricity, we're always going to be at the oil company's whim, whatever they want to do with us. And it's hard.
Yep, uh-huh, I think so, because of the import and export. That's why it's gone up.
I do think it is part from that, but I also think with the higher gas prices, it costs more money to transport the food to the stores, and everything goes up in price.
Very true. Any final thoughts, final words, anything?
On the oil prices and thing like that? Yeah, you know, we should be investing in finding out alternate solutions to that crisis.
Yeah, I'd like to say this to every American. Start walking, half of you are fat. There we go.
Yes. Take your money, stock is down. You can buy it for cheap, you'll go up later. If you put your money in the stock market, guys, and you'll get a good huge return in the future, okay? That's a good way to invest.
All right, thank you, Mr. Bob.
The Predatory Lender presents Blood Money, March 4th, 2011, starring Rossana Woo.